Morning mates, welcome to the SleepHQ Academy. In today's lesson, I'll teach you how to import your CPAP SD card data using a Windows-based PC or laptop. We'll take it nice and slow, step by step. Let's begin. Okay, step number one, we need to remove our SD card from our CPAP machine and we need to somehow connect it to our PC or laptop. Now here's my AirSense 10. The SD card is located in the side. I just press it in, ta-da, pull out the SD card. Now with my laptop, there is no slot in the side to connect this SD card. So I had to purchase an external SD card reader that has a USB cable, okay? So you can find these anywhere. They're very cheap and affordable, around $10. So I just connect up the USB to the USB port on the laptop. And now I can insert the SD card into the reader. And that's step one done. Step two, we need to locate the files on the SD card, and then we need to drag them into the imports folder in SleepHQ, and we'll go through that now. So step two, let's locate the files on the SD card. So on your Windows PC or laptop, you need to go to File Explorer, and then down the left here, you'll see USB drive. Click the USB drive. And here we have the two folders and the three files on the SD card. Step three, we need to log into our SleepHQ account and access the data imports menu. So here is my SleepHQ account. And on the left-hand side down here, you can see it says data imports. Click data imports. And now step four, we need to get the files from the SD card and drag them over into the data imports section. Let's do that now. So step one, select machine type. Let's click that. Select the type of machine you have from the drop-down list below. Now I know I've got an AirSense 10 here, so you just need to choose whatever machine you have. Series 10 AirSense, there's mine. Okay, step two, add the files. Now drag all the files and folders from the SD card into the file upload box below. If you can't drag and drop because you're on a mobile phone, click here. While we're on a laptop, so we can drag and drop. So come across to where your SD card files are located. And there's a few ways you can do this here. You can do Control A, which will select them all. That's probably the easiest. Or you can also click and drag your mouse over all the files. But you can see they're all selected now, all the files. And I'm just going to click and drag them across. You can see it's dragging five files into this little box here and then release. Pretty easy, right? And now you can see I have a green tick next to each of the files I dragged in. That's what you want to see. You want to make sure you have a green tick next to each of those files. Let's just say I didn't have a green tick next to the data log folder. There's a chance when I selected all the files, I might have missed one. So just go back, grab whatever one you're missing, bring it in, and make sure you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 green ticks. And then you're good to go. Now we'll just scroll down a little bit. You can see here it's got a nice big blue button that says begin upload. I'll click begin upload. Now if it's your first time doing an upload, there's a good chance you have a lot of data on that SD card. So your first upload might take quite a while. So just go and make a cup of tea, hang tight, make sure you stay on this page. Don't navigate away from the page until that upload is complete. Once the upload's complete, SleepHQ will start processing the files and compiling all the charts and information for you to view. So as soon as that upload's complete, yes, you can start going around and looking around the app, navigating away from this main page. But while that upload is going, just make sure you stay on the page, okay? But that's it. Once it's complete, if we scroll down here, you'll have a list of your past data imports. And you can see the one I've just done here. Data from March 3rd to April 4th, 2022, CPAP. And there it is here. December 15th, 2022, 9:36 a.m. And it should say complete next to it. Once you've done that, you can go to your dashboard. Although your initial upload might take a little bit of time, future uploads will be much faster as SleepHQ will only process the new files added. So just do the exact same steps, drag all the files and folders from your SD card into SleepHQ. Don't worry about it, SleepHQ will only process the new files. Once you've done that, we need to put our SD card back into our CPAP machine. So go back to File Explorer where the SD card is. Down here where the SD card is located, right click and click Eject to safely eject the SD card. Safe to remove hardware. Take your SD card out. And plug it back in your CPAP machine. It's that easy. Now, if you can't be bothered doing SD card uploads, dragging all your files into SleepHQ all the time, you might consider buying what's called a magic uploader, which is a little device Adam and I created that automatically sends all the SD card data via a Wi-Fi SD card using your home Wi-Fi to SleepHQ. I'll put a link in the description down below. Have a great day, guys. Look forward to seeing you in the next lesson. Cheers.